Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs. And in today's class I will be dealing with a very important topic related to agriculture and the environment of agriculture. So in today's topic I will be dealing with the impact of tropospheric ozone on the productivity and yield in the agriculture sector. Tropospheric ozone. Recently, a lot of research has been conducted on the impact of ozone on the agriculture productivity. Now, before we discuss this, it is important to understand and know the importance of studying the impact of this gas on Indian agriculture. Now, because India is an agriculture nation, most of the population is engaged in the agriculture sector, and anything that impacts agriculture influences the GDP of our country, influences the employment and output and productivity of agriculture in India. And agriculture is a favorite topic of UPSC. There has not even been a single year when a question on agriculture would not have been asked. So it is a favorite area. So you must understand agriculture from different dimensions. And this is another dimension of exploring how the yield of agriculture will get impacted because of tropospheric ozone. Now, when it comes to ozone as a gas, now ozone as a gas, it actually protects the earth from ultraviolet radiations. Now, it protects the earth from ultraviolet radiation when ozone is present in stratosphere. Now, this is very important. In stratosphere, it has a benign effect, it has a positive effect. It is good for the health of the earth as a planet to have ozone at this level because it will be protecting us from UV radiation. But when this ozone is present at the tropospheric level, now what is the tropospheric level? It is the lowest level of the atmosphere. Now atmosphere has got different layers. There is troposphere, there is stratosphere, there is mesosphere, there is ionosphere, and there is exosphere. Now, these are the different layers of the atmosphere. And troposphere is the lowest layer of the atmosphere. And in this layer, we have such gases which makes it possible to have life on Earth. And when it comes to the availability of ozone in the troposphere, it is actually rising day by day. Now, why this ozone is rising? The levels of ozone are rising in the troposphere. Now, when it comes to ozone, because it will have a negative impact on the productivity of the agriculture. Now, why it has a negative impact? This will be discussing in the later part of the lecture. Now, when it comes to ozone and its presence in the troposphere, it is actually not a primary pollutant. There are two types of pollutants basically. One is a primary pollutant, and the second is secondary pollutant. Now, when it pollutant is not primary, then how it is actually formed? And what all are the primary pollutants? The primary pollutant is or are like nitrogen dioxide or nitrogen oxide or methane or various volatile carbon compounds. These are the primary pollutants. Now, when these primary pollutants, they basically react, they undergo a photochemical reaction, means when these pollutants they undergo a chemical reaction or a photochemical reaction, they actually result in producing secondary pollutants. And ozone is one of the secondary pollutants. Now, since the days of industrialization and due to the impact, anthropogenic impact, this ozone level is increasing day by day in the tropospheric level. And how can we cater to this tropospheric level? Now, if we want to cater to this ozone at the tropospheric level, we need to actually hit at the primary pollutants. We need to actually take care of these primary ones. Because if we will stop the increase in the presence of these primary pollutants, only then we will be able to cater to this ozone's increasing intensity and increasing level in the troposphere. Now, for a developing country like India, because we need to discuss it from India's perspective, for a developing country like India, where agriculture plays a very important role, this ozone that gets exhibited in the atmosphere as a secondary pollutant, it can actually come to countries like India from the Western world. It is not a necessity that ozone should be getting or ozone should be getting produced only in India to impact India. There is a huge amount of transfer of ozone in the atmosphere. Now, the ozone that is actually being produced in North American continent, in countries like USA and Canada, it actually gets transported and transferred to the European countries where it impacts their agriculture. And that is the reason why the presence of ozone in the troposphere, it is also known as background ozone, because we don't know the origin. Now, this is very important, the origin of ozone. What is the parent source of the origin of this ozone in the troposphere? But it will have an impact on the agriculture of the developing countries. So for a country like India, it is the biggest concern to have higher yields from agriculture. India will be the most populous country by 2040 or 2035, and in order to meet the food requirements of such a huge population, India will certainly need a lot of productivity from the agriculture. We will need to actually enhance that. And that can be done if we will take care of all the factors that are inhibiting the productivity of agriculture. And that is the reason that why we are doing this editorial, why we are analyzing the impact of this secondary pollutant on the agriculture of India. Now, how this ozone impacts the agriculture, this is another thing that we will be learning now. Now, ozone as a layer, ozone as a gas, it actually enters the stomata. It enters the stomata of a plant. The stomata is a place where the gas exchange takes place in a plant. Now, when ozone will enter the stomata of a plant, of a flower, then and there it will cause the oxidation process to take place, and that oxidation process will lead to a kind of a crisis in the plant, in the physiology of the plant, and that it will also lead to the yellowing of the leaves of the plant. It will also lead to the early death of the plant. It will also lead to the lowering of the productivity of a crop. So it is how the ozone will be impacting the stomata. And for a country like India, its impact could range any something between 20 to 30% in the reduction of the yield from the crop. So the organizations who are working in the agriculture sector, like Indian Council of Agriculture Research, they should actually be focusing on this element and how to cater to this pollutant that might endanger the food security and productivity of a country like India. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. And for reading the editorial decodes, for watching the editorial decodes and reading the current affairs and downloading MCQs for the day, you can visit our website brainyias.com. There we have launched a new kind of a program named as IAS Library. In IAS Library, you will be getting the current affairs, the MCQs, and the question and answers on a daily basis. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.